Hey, it's 20 February. I'm just leaving, having met with another tribal council, and headed back home to get back to work, back to the office to get back to work on everything that still needs to happen. So, council presentation, I think went pretty good. I feel it went a little bit better than my last one a couple of days ago. Just because I had another chance to guest rehearse and share it. Felt like this one came more from my heart of what I was trying to say and was able to share my feelings a little bit better through my words. And one comment that one of the tribal council ladies, one of the councilwomen said was, she's like, "So who are you looking for? You're looking for just anybody that can go and like walk from, you tell them to walk from here to there and then they walk around here." And I understood what she was asking after a second, that she was basically think we were looking for extras in the film, and I had to clarify. It's like, no, we're here looking for all, you know, our, we have 15 actors, the lead roles. We're looking for any community members that it's like they have a shot to be the lead in the movie, who's going to be on the poster. And after explaining that for just a second, then it was fun to see like her get what I was saying, and her understanding, like, you're wanting some of our community members or our community to be involved with the actual real actors and you know, more than background actors, which background are important and stuff too. That's how I got my start, as being a background actor. So but yes, it was fun for me to see that, and it reminded me I had that experience, I think, on Turquoise Rose when we were auditioning, that people were asking for. We were holding auditions, I don't remember where it was, on the Navajo Nation Summit, a chapter somewhere, Shiprock or Windrock. We held them all over, and I remember one of the person or two that were saying, well, who are the leads going to be? Who are the stars going to be in this movie? And we had to like, well, we're looking for the stars. That's why we're here. And to see the light bulb go on with that lady, you know, back in Navajo land over, what was that, 10, 12 years ago. And then to have that same kind of experience again today, as, you know, as I stood there before tribal council, it was a good feeling, a good thing that to help her understand and to catch a little bit more of the vision of what we're trying to do, that we are looking for our leads and background actors and, you know, those that can help us to make this film. So that was kind of the highlight from that, and had a positive response, a handful of questions from the council and stuff. So I was honored to be able to be there and to be able to have the few minutes to present before council. I know there's a lot of important things they're working on, and, you know, running a nation, I'm sure, as I've said before, I'm sure isn't the easiest thing to do. I have no idea how that would be. But it was good. I'm pleased with that, and I leave not knowing whether, you know, something will happen or not on this project. I hope something will, but regardless, I feel like our mission of what we're trying to do has gotten out a little bit further, and so that's worth my trip driving to the community. And also after that, I was able to go and visit the senior center, caught him when it was just one guy there getting, you know, wrapping some forks and spoons and knives, getting stuff ready for lunch. And so I was able to visit with him and look at the facility and just other options of possibly where we could make the film. So, and then from there I stopped at the cultural center and tried to put up some more flyers in the community of, you know, actors that we're looking for and such. So that's, you know, spent about half a day getting, you know, it'll be probably 6 hours or so on this trip, basically to meet with a tribal council and to put up a few flyers and try to get the word out there a little bit. But I think in big picture, long term, anytime I have a chance just to build stronger relations, to make more, you know, honest friends, that it's worth my effort and time to do that. And hopefully I hope it was worth tribal council's time to hear me for a few minutes. And by their response, I want to say, that it was, or they're all really good actors and just nice people. Or maybe all of that combined. So I headed back home to the office. I still have a lot of work to try to get, you know, back to marketing. Marketing is something when I'm struggling with, like, what's the next step? Where do I spend my time? Marketing is always has their hand up there in the front row saying, pick me, you can always do more marketing and stuff. But so that's there, and I printed off the script yesterday. I've got to go through right now and break down the script. So I'll probably, when I get home, I'll start doing that, breaking it down, and then I've got to get the budget, that kind of worst case scenario budget there, so I really know what that number is that we need for the worst case scenario. Even though we've already landed one check, that as far as I know, it didn't bounce. We've got to know what that number is, and to get to that real number is, okay, we've got to get locations and, you know, number of shooting days, like all of that comes to breaking down the script. So I'll walk you through how to break down a script. I learned from a couple of guys, a local commercial producer here in Phoenix, and then a guy that was out of Hollywood that worked on some big movies as a first assistant director. Well, both of them are first ADs, and so they're the two that I really learned how to break a script down and such. So I'll walk you through that.